we made the compass, we used electricity to create a magnetic field. With generators, the exact opposite also works. There's a bunch of magnets and a bunch of coils of wire. If we can get these spinning, it generates an electric potential. I've reshaped the DVD drive case to become a propeller. I'm using a piece of my hiking stick as a shaft to keep the generator away from the water. When the current turns my DVD tray propeller, the hiking stick shaft will also spin, turning the generator, which will produce electricity for as long as the water flows. You gotta figure out the right position, but then the river just kinda takes it, and it just keeps going. You got free energy. This is awesome. Got my camp lit up. Now I need to focus on the flow. Can't get this idea of the flash floods out of my mind. The rain that comes from all over the ridge can drop in here. So I'm trying to build myself a kind of early warning system. So when the water raises too quickly, it's gonna have a string that goes over it. This is gonna start flying with the water. It's gonna tug on it to trigger my alarm. And I'll know I need to get out of here. I've spent 3 days in this challenging jungle. I need to make it out tomorrow no matter what. To do that, I have to get plenty of sleep tonight. Last night I was hearing the bug zapper go all night long, but I was still just getting eaten up in that grass hole. I think it might be because I'm building up all this CO2 while I'm breathing, and the mosquitoes are really drawn to that as well as this bright blue light. When an animal's going after something, they don't like it just for one reason. They like it for many different reasons. If it looks tasty, it smells tasty, and it feels tasty, that means it's probably really tasty. So what I need to do is figure out a way to pump this CO2 that I'm excreting out away from my body and lure them into this death trap that I'm setting up for those mosquitoes. If I can get both this really attractive light and this really delicious smelling CO2 in the same container, the insects will hopefully just go nuts for it, and we'll get a bunch of those mosquitoes in there and away from me. I'm pulling out this fan that we just got from the computer here. This will be my main air pump. The fans and laptops are really nice because the thin profile, it makes whatever air it's pumping take a 90 degree angle. So I can put this on my face, it'll spin and pump all the air away. Now, I'm gonna need something to carry it further away from my body than just right here. So I'm looking to make a tube out of some of this space blanket material I got. It's a really thin mylar. It's just kind of like a bag. If I can make a nice tube out of that, attach it to the fan, and run it into my bug zapper, we're gonna have a beautiful, hanging, glowing ball of death that'll keep all the mosquitoes busy while leaving me alone. So once we got the fan, it can go up to my face and it can pump this CO2 away. Now, I'm gonna need something to carry this CO2 a little bit further. So, I've got this kind of aluminum backing foil that came out of the laptop. I could probably mold that pretty decently to get a decent seal over my face, mount the fan onto it, hook up the tube, and have my own kind of CPAP rebreather style machine that'll lull me to sleep, maybe even stop me from snoring, and kill all the mosquitoes in the jungle, hopefully. My CO2 is pushed along the tube by my laptop. There's the smoke! There's smoke coming! It's attached to the inside of my mask. That bamboo kicked my ass all day, but now I've tamed it. I've got a beautiful shelter out of it, and I've got dinner. It's kind of like a bitter carrot if you eat it raw, but warming it up a bit, maybe breaking down some of that bitterness, making it taste a little bit better.